Let me introduce myself. My name is Dr. Sridhar. I am working as director here and in the Amity School of Engineering and Technology, Amity University, Gurugram. My educational backgrounds are I did BE in Mechanical Engineering, obtained my master's degree and PhD in Aerospace Engineering from Indian Institute of Science, IISE. I have about 33 years of experience in engineering education, research and administration, and I have carried out several research projects and consultancy projects successfully. I have also served as education and career counselor through media for several years. I have also won professional awards for my research and educational activities. Today, let us start with knowing that what is engineering. As all we know, engineering involves the application of science to build application tools, machines, structures, gadgets, and so on. So what you see in this picture here, science is the basic foundation for engineering. And engineering actually stands on this science in terms of, you know, its application. Since it is the application part of the established scientific principles, the study of engineering involves innovation towards realizing the dreams of building interesting, useful engineering products. Few of them are shown here, starting from civil engineering, electronics, computer science, and machineries, and so on. Now, engineering can be studied under the following main streams. Basically, there are about more than 100 streams. I have taken only a few of them, which you can call it as the main streams, and through which you can also see the branchification. The first one which I am mentioning here is about computer science and engineering. These are not in a particular format or a particular hierarchy. I'll just take one by one. Electrical, electronics and communication engineering, mechanical engineering, civil engineering, biomedical and biotechnology engineering, aeronautical aerospace engineering, and there are multiple interdisciplinary engineerings which are connected to many of these and also you knew of, I mean, other than these also. There's a question here. I request Juneja sir to actually open the poll question here. The question for the participants, although engineering is studied under many disciplines, the actual application of engineering in real field needs knowledge and skills in multidisciplinary fields. So participants, what do you feel? Please press 1 if it is true and 2 if it is false.
So they are participating in.
Thank you. Now I will go to some details about computer science and engineering. It integrates several engineering aspects related to computer science and electronics engineering towards developing hardware and software. There are a few thrust areas in computer science engineering. Artificial intelligence is also one part of it. Architectures and compilers, data mining, databases, graphics and visualization, networks, systems and security, software engineering, programming languages, object-oriented programming and software development, designing and analyzing algorithms for scientific and engineering applications. Firstly, please understand CS is not a single entity. Under that, there are multiple components and multiple branches under which each one of them you can actually lead to you know, a better career, as well as into the higher studies and also to research. Now the same thing I have shown here in the computer science engineering, we have artificial intelligence, architecture and compilers, data mining and data analysis, graphics and visualization, network and system security, software engineering, object-oriented programs and design of algorithms. Many things will be added up to computer science and engineering stream. Now let me just take up a small thing, because everybody is talking about artificial intelligence and machine learning nowadays, and there's a great demand in the public as well as from the students, engineering students, aspirants also. If I say artificial intelligence refers to the capability of an engineering system to demonstrate the cognitive skills of self-learning and problem solving. So artificial intelligence actually has two major things. One is self-learning and problem solving. And artificial intelligence need not be always a robot. Please remember, it's a part of it. And therefore, artificial intelligence can be inculcated through proper algorithms. What is the main objectives of the artificial intelligence? Recognizing patterns and decision making, that is one part. Speeding up repetitive procedures with the help of robots or machines. And mimic human brains through learning and memory. All three are actually the main objectives of the artificial intelligence as an entity. The application of AI is widespread and is used in almost all fields. Best example is a recent application of artificial intelligence in handling COVID-19 situation. Probably all of you have heard, many countries are already into, you know, using artificial intelligence for combating COVID-19, including India. If you have noticed that when you visit a commercial website on an internet and return to other portals such as Facebook, the advertisement related to the page you visited start appearing. You may wonder, how did this come to know that I was interested in this product? In fact, you should understand the moment actually you get into a particular website, somebody is following you at the background. And those somebody will try to understand what is your interest and what is your, the interest in which you are going to take up. And based on that, they start actually popping up many things. This is a simple example of US use of artificial intelligence in commercial applications. Artificial intelligence is reshaping and redefining we may live and work, and artificial intelligence powers many programs and services that become integral part of everyday life. And in fact, you would have already experienced AI, but without even knowing that it is being used. And there are multiple, you know, components with AI itself. For example, you start with AI in the machine learning, deep learning, cyber security, tourism, automotive industry, military and intelligence, finance and banking, medical, robotics, natural language processing, computer vision, speech processing. You name whatever the branches of applications, we have artificial intelligence in almost everything. There are focused applications of artificial intelligence in 2020. Quickly, I'll go through that. You would have heard of smarter cars, self-driving and parking vehicles, and as a robotic assistant like home and service robots, collaborative robots, and also in the healthcare. See, for example, the patient's risk on the health is actually predicted using artificial intelligence. There are wearable devices which uses artificial intelligence devices, and there are robots actually which support surgery, and remote surgery or medi-surgery also can be done from this. And if you look at retails, artificial intelligence in retails goes through virtual trial rooms, digital assistants, better data accumulation, map monitoring, targeted marketing campaigns, and similarly, the chatbots are there. Probably whenever you are entering into a particular website, see, for example, if you come to Amity University Gurugram website, there will be a chat window which will pop up, which will say, hello, I am so-and-so. Do you like any help from me regarding admission or what, etc. In fact, this is actually not a person, but in the name of a person, a chat bot means a robot of chat is actually, acting on it, and therefore it is asking questions. And when you write something, the chatbots are so intelligent nowadays, it will try to understand what is your intent. And based on that, they try to give you proper answers also. And similarly, in the cybersecurity itself, there are a lot many advances which artificial intelligence has brought in. There is also digital intelligence. And then digital intelligence solutions will help organizations to increase their business and their critical ability in optimizing automation initiatives, etc. And the digital workers will transform the office nowadays. So this is the whole, the transformation which is happening nowadays with the inclusion of AI. And according to new IDC research, the contribution of digital workers, such as software robots and AI, will grow over by 50% by 2022. Let me just make a small, intervention in this particular statement. And let me tell you, many of you may be wondering, then why I should actually study any of my courses here? Because most of these are being taken away by robots and powered by AI. But I'll tell you one thing, the moment actually we come out with a new technology, there is always an option for you to become a creator of that technology. So that means there will be more and more new openings for you to actually develop a lot of AI algorithms and also develop AI systems and so on. So therefore, do not get scared away. In fact, you need to learn these, and these will help you in boosting your career also. And then with IoT is also there are two statements which I just want to bring it to you. IoT is Internet of Things, probably you would have understood. And in an Internet of Things context, artificial intelligence has become a prerequisite for dealing with the data volume sensors produce. This is a statement by Richard Soley. There's one more statement, Sriram Raghavan, Vice President of IBM Research, has said, using AI to help automate the steps and processes involved in the life cycle of creating, deploying, managing, and operating AI models to help scale AI more widely into the enterprise. Don't get confused. It is simply called AI for AI. So use AI to develop better AI. That's the meaning of this particular statement. Now, there is one more statement which I just want to bring it to your notice. Whoever leads in artificial intelligence in 2030 will rule the world until 2100, and I would say beyond also. This is a statement, a powerful statement for artificial intelligence. There's a poll question too for the participants here. The question is, study of artificial intelligence is more of engineering and therefore not much of as his or field of study. You know what I mean to say? If you want to learn artificial intelligence, does it mean that you don't have to study mathematics properly, but still you can perform better in artificial intelligence? You say either true or false. Juneja, sir, you can just open the poll, please.
Sir, I've done it, and the results are known. People are participating in it. As of now, 69 and then 66% have said no. And I'll share in a minute.
Okay. Let me put my argument here.
Yeah.
Please understand, artificial intelligence has a base with mathematics. I will be showing in the next slide here what are the desirable skills for learning AI. Please note down, they have a very strong hold on mathematics like statistics, probability, predictions, calculus, algebra, Bayesian algorithms, and Boolean algebra. All these are very important to learn artificial intelligence. So anybody who hates mathematics, please, you know, start loving mathematics so that you can become a good artificial intelligence engineer. You should also have good hold on science like physics, mechanics, cognitive learning theory, language processing, and you should have knowledge and skill of computer programming. The question is, I don't know computer programming, can I come to AI? Of course, at the entry level, you have to learn computer programming. Suppose I say any UG program, they start with a computer programming and then they'll switch over to higher levels of AI. And in that, basically data structures, programming, logic, and efficiency also will come into picture. You should have good data analytical skills, which you can develop through the course. And you should have will to develop logics and learn machine languages. This is very, very important. And you should be capable of creating algorithms for finding patterns and learnings. These are the desirable skills for learning AI. And anybody who has good skills of these will become a very good AI engineer. What are the educational and job prospects of AI? Many reputed institutes and universities, including Amity University, Gurugram, offer UG and PG courses in AI. And I cannot list only a few of them for your, the job prospectives. AI experts with right skills in practice of AI are in great demand in many fields, starting from automotive industry right up to the healthcare. So this is about the AI part, and I will not be dealing much with other components of CSE or computer science and engineering. I need to take up all the other branches of disciplines of engineering as well. And if you have particular questions, you continue to listen to it and you will see that how all branches or all disciplines of engineering are interrelated. You cannot say that I will learn AI and I don't want to learn something from civil or something from mechanical or electronics. I will take up the next branch of engineering, not in a particular hierarchy, that is electrical engineering. Electrical engineering is a basic engineering stream which deals with electric machines, instrumentation and control, electricity generation and distribution, smart energy management, renewable energy resources, and many more. Electrical engineering includes the application of physics and mathematics. Please understand, this also involves physics and mathematics, and the physics of electricity, electromagnetism, and electronics like macro, micro, and nano electronics also comes into electrical engineering. These will be useful to build the engineering systems and transmission of energy. Now you can see many of these pictures here. Probably you can understand this is a metro, which is basically driven by electrical drives. And this is a control panel, maybe in a power station. And this is the transmission system that is being used. Electrical heavy machinery, the lighting, electrical vehicles, etc. All this will come under electrical engineering. Now if you look at what are the sub-branches of electrical engineering or the sub-topics of electrical engineering, initially you will see electrical machines, instrumentation and control, electricity generation and distribution, smart energy management, renewable energy resources, lighting and wiring, signal processing, microelectronics, and many more. These are the main branches of electrical engineering through which anybody can find their further career, also further research opportunities. Now, what are the desirable skills for electrical engineering? As you can see, again, you need to learn mathematics properly. So basically, the same thing like calculus, algebra, vector algebra is very important. Vector calculus is important, and tensors are also important. Probably you would have studied in plus two about the calculus and also the algebra. You will have to learn vector algebra, vector calculus, and tensors to have a very strong hold on electrical engineering. And these are a must in most of all the electrical and electronics branches, and as well as other branches. These mathematics is a backbone. You also should have the knowledge of physics, chemistry, and material science. These will be useful in understanding many of the aspects which I just showed you now. You should have good analytical skills, good problem solving skills. There is one important thing. You should be a good team player and team lead attitude. Please understand, electrical engineering is a highly professional career, wherein you will have to involve with many people, and also you need to actually command people. In other words, you have to take the work from your team players, and you need to actually command also, means you have to lead that. So you should have a good team player and team lead attitude, and you should be capable of understanding circuits, networks, and developing algorithms. Of course, actually you can start actually developing these type of skills at the end, but you should have some love, or you should have some orientation to make these understandings. These are the major things for electrical engineering. Now, what are the job opportunities for educational job opportunities for electrical engineer? As I said earlier, many reputed institutes and universities, including Amity University, Gurugram, offer UG and PG programs in electrical engineering. There are a lot of job opportunities for electrical engineering. I have shown a few of them here. For example, you say central and state electricity boards, which comes under government of India and state governments, all industries and establishments, central power production and distribution centers, electrical machine and equipment manufacturers and service providers, certified energy auditors, defense research organizations. And remember, electrical engineers also are taken in software and IT industry and many more. Maybe you may be wondering that how come that the people who are studying electrical engineering can get into software and IT industry. Maybe I will touch up this at the end of my session. Now, lot many opportunities are there for electrical engineers, as I have shown here. Now, I come to the next branch, electronics and communication engineering. Probably all of you would have already seen this conventional thing. Electronics engineering is a subset of electrical engineering, which uses principles of electrical engineering to design and build passive electronical devices, such as printed circuit boards, VLSI devices, embedded systems, and so on. And if you look at electronics and communication engineering, what all it includes? It includes telecommunication, signals and systems, network analysis, control systems, microelectronics, embedded system design, microwave and radar, audio processing, satellite communication, and many more. To make it more picturesque, I've shown a few of those pictures here. Probably you will immediately understand what all those things. All the electronic items in and around you are shown here, including the personal gadgets which you are using in the form of the wristwatch and many other. Similarly, I will show you a few more here. Probably you will understand everything. I don't want to dwell upon more on this. And now if you also look at here, a few of them have been shown representative way. A VLSI design, very large scale integration of the chip design, macroelectronics, microelectronics, networking, and then radar and the antenna, also the satellite communication, all those will come under electronics and communication engineering. And same thing quickly, I'll go through that. VLSI system, communication system, network analysis, image processing, microelectronics, microwave radar, audio processing, network analysis, and lot many of such things are included in electronics and communication engineering. And similarly, image processing is a very powerful tool and is being used in many, many fields, which is actually, much, much better dealt in electronics engineering and electronics and communication engineering. One quickly, I just wanted to show it to you. You are seeing here on food processing industry, there will be an image processing, which actually, is used basically to segregate the ripe fruits and also the raw fruits, also the rotten fruits and also the ripe fruits, etc. And these are done with the image processing. You would have also heard about many other applications, as I have seen here. I will not take much time on this. There is a poll question here, and I want Juneja sir to open it up. Electronics engineer has only option of working with electronic hardware and does not fit well with computer oriented jobs. So participant, please participate in this, either true or false into it. Okay. I will let you know what is the answer. Probably you know. Electronics engineer are also actually preferred in computer oriented jobs because the type of applications which I have shown, all the electronic components come with programming, especially the embedded programming, and you require the computer knowledge for it, and therefore the computer software jobs also actually prefer electronics and communication engineers as well. And what are the desirable skills to learn? As usual in electrical engineering, strong hold on mathematics, knowledge on physics, good analytical skills, problem solving skills. And you should actually be able to love, or you know, love to create electronic gadgets. Many people will have some sort of, you know, inclination towards it. You should be a good team player, and you should be capable of understanding circuits, networks, and developing algorithms. What are the job opportunities? As you can see here, job opportunities are again, central and state electricity boards are there, mobile developing and manufacturing units, network operators, all industries and establishment of any nature, aviation and space research organizations, electronic gadget manufacturing industries, software and IT industries, defense research organizations, and many more. So the opportunities are many more. It is left to the participant actually to choose a particular branch and then find their career. Now I come to mechanical engineering, one of the oldest part of engineering, discipline of engineering. Mechanical engineering is an engineering discipline that combines engineering, physics, and mathematics principles with material science to design, analyze, manufacture, and maintain mechanical systems. This I have taken from Wikipedia, a correct statement. And what all it includes, basically it includes mechanics, dynamics, fluid and heat transfer, structural analysis, material science, thermodynamics and manufacturing, robotics and machine design as its main components. Now you can see plenty of such type of photographs which I have shown. The heavy vehicles are the heavy transfer, you know, the mining heavy, equipments, the cranes, and also the robots. You can see there is a series of robots which are making an assembly in a car manufacturing line here. And similarly, you also see them in basically the power generation. These are the type of the turbines which are used in the power plants. And even in that, mechanical engineering is applied. Many more are there. As you can see, there are turbines, the hydraulic turbines, aircraft turbines, steam turbines, oil rigs, and so on. Now the components which you have in this is fluid mechanics and heat transfer, machine design, industrial management, mechanics, robotics, manufacturing, computer aided drawing and design, automotive, structural analysis, thermodynamics, energy, and power. Not many things are there. What are the desirable skills again? Please remember, almost all the engineering fields require mathematics. So a strong hold on mathematics, a small change in this. We don't use much of Boolean algebra here, but calculus, vector algebra, vector calculus, and tensors are required here. Of course, you should have strong knowledge on physics, chemistry, and material science, and you should have engineering three-dimensional space. See, there is one extra skill which you need to have here. You should actually start imagining or innovation in three-dimensional space. Innovation attitude to develop mechanical systems, good analytical skills, problem-solving skills, love to create mechanical gadgets. And you should also be a good team player. Of course, all mechanical engineers work in team, and you should be capable of understanding mechanisms and flow of fluid and heat transfer. What are the job opportunities? As you can see, central and state mechanical establishments, public sector undertakings, all industries and establishments, automotive, railway, aircraft industries, central power production and distribution centers, manufacturing units and service providers, public works department, defense research organizations, and many more, many more. So there's no limit for mechanical engineers to grab a job, including software engineering, which are not specifically written. Even in software engineering, as well as in IT industry, mechanical engineers are preferred because most of the mechanical engineer systems are basically coupled with electronics and computer science. And we need somebody who has the knowledge of mechanical engineering to design these gadgets and programs. There's a poll question number four here. It's a very interesting question which people usually ask. Mechanical engineering is more suitable for men rather than women because it involves many activities that need muscle power and ruggedness. True or false? Again, participants, please vote for it. And Juneja sir, I hope you are taking the poll.
Yes, yes, sir. 75% as of now have said false, and it is changing.
Very good. Basically, it is false.
Results, are 70% are saying it is false, 30% are saying it's true. So, you can please explain it.
I think all of you have understood very clearly why it is false. Earlier, people were thinking mechanical engineer means he should have always a spanner in his hand or a hammer in a hand, and always, you know, should peep under the tree, under the chassis of an automobile, and etc., etc. But you remember, there are a lot of white-collar jobs as well in mechanical engineering, number one. Number two, we cannot actually underlook the capability or the empowerment of women. Women are participating in military applications, etc., and so on. In such cases, this is definitely another opportunity for the woman to seek through. Now, let me go to the civil engineering. Civil engineering is a professional engineering discipline that deals with the design, construction, and maintenance of the physical and naturally built environment, including public works such as roads, bridges, canals, dams, airports, sewage systems, pipelines, structural components of buildings, railways. And military engineering is also the very oldest engineering discipline in the world. Basically, people say that military engineering was the very first discipline in engineering, and which followed with the civil engineering. And it also has, you know, a lot of appearances in almost everything in the life. I can show you a few of them here. Building a bridges and you know, the flyovers, and doing geotechnical work, constructions, highway engineering, transport engineering, and many more. There's a question here for all of you, just to small check on your general knowledge. Which is the tallest man-made structure in the world at present? Statue of Liberty, Statue of Unity, Burj Khalifa, Empire State Building. Dinesh sir will be taking the poll.
Four % are saying Statue of Liberty, 24% approx are saying Statue of Unity, 70% are saying Burj Khalifa, and 1% is saying Empire State Building, USA.
Please observe, the answer is here only. Starting from 1825, see how the technology is actually transforming everything. And in 2020, how actually, you know, you are having Burj Khalifa. Burj Khalifa is the highest one at present with 890 meters, and that is the right answer. And the moment actually you say this is the tallest structure, please understand what should be the type of the structural strength that has been provided at the bottom. How did they actually, you know, provide such a thin, slender structure for such a long distance, etc.? All this you learn in civil engineering. Very, very interesting engineering branch, of course. And civil engineering also involves structural and construction engineering, geotechnical engineering, building materials, hydraulics and water resource and irrigation engineering, surveying, remote sensing and GIS, environmental engineering, transportation engineering, signal processing, architecture and town planning, and lot many other branches. Other, you know, the disciplines are also added to civil engineering. What are the desirable calculus, skills here? Please remember, mathematics has slightly shown reduced here. Doesn't mean that you don't require very high mathematics. You require, of course, if you go into the research. But the minimum thing what is required is basically the calculus and algebra. And of course, the knowledge of physics, chemistry, material science, and again, the imagination or intuitiveness in three-dimensional space is also very, very important. Innovation attitude to develop structural systems, good analytical skills, good problem-solving skills, love to work with civil structure. This is very important for you. And of course, civil is also highly, team activity. And therefore, a civil engineer should be a good team player, and a team lead attitude you should have. And of course, you should love field visits and field works. Now, there's another question here for the polling. Civil engineers are not preferred in software and IT industry. Please poll whether true or false.
Sir, approx 60% are saying no, 30-40% are saying yes.
Yes, please understand, civil engineers are also actually very much desired in many of our software industry. I will show you what are the types of software that are being used in construction apps and software. You can see lot many softwares are being used by civil engineers. It is true in any of the part of any discipline of engineering. These are actually, you know, the design especially for solving some of the problems. Who will design these types of, you know, the softwares? It is, of course, the people who have civil engineering knowledge and also know how to program it. In fact, it is a team of civil engineers, computer science engineers, mechanical engineers, and of course, to a part of, you know, electronic engineers as well. All of them will come. So therefore, there is a lot more demand, even in the software also, for the civil engineers. And what are the educational and job opportunities? Basically, you must be knowing a lot many job opportunities are there for civil engineering, like civil construction companies, design engineer. You can work as a design engineer with any architect, and railways and harbors and airports, irrigation department, Survey of India, all public sector and research institutes, municipalities, city corporation, public works department, pollution control boards, defense organizations, software and IT industry, and so on. There is no limit for civil engineering, again, for finding a career. I come to a special branch of engineering called biomedical engineering. BME, or medical engineering, is an application of engineering principles and design concepts to medicine and biology for healthcare purposes, like diagnostic or therapeutic. Basically, this is a very fantastic combination of the medical aspect, the medicine aspect, biology aspect, and engineering aspect. Probably I'll give you a small examples through some of the figures, some of the pictures later. Let me just read out this sentence. This field seeks to close the gap between engineering and medicine, combining the design and problem-solving skills of engineering with medical biological sciences to advance healthcare treatment, including diagnosis, monitoring, and therapy. I'll show some of them. As you can see here, the medical instrumentation, the prosthetics, the artificial organs, and there are a lot many clinical practices, the robotic arm, which is actually built with bionic sensors, and also basically what you see here is the use of CAD, actually, you know, to model one of the bones, and again the bone joint, etc. There are a lot of medical equipments also comes into this particular branch of engineering. So biomedical branch of engineering involves many things. For example, it actually go with biomaterial, bioinformatics, biosignal processing, tissue engineering, medical imaging, biomedical sensors, bionics, prosthetics, and many more. In today's world, there is a large demand for biomedical engineers, basically because lot many systems are required to be developed for many patients, and these require an understanding of both engineering part of it and as well as the medicine part of it, or the medical arena of it. So therefore, there is a lot demand for biomedical engineers on this. And biomedical engineering is highly interdisciplinary. You need mechanical engineering, which uses 3D modeling, finite element analysis, electromechanical devices like transducer, measurement, computer. This comes under electronics as well. Machine learning, artificial intelligence comes from computer science. Medical equipment applications and design, electronics again. And medical imaging and software algorithm for disease is a multidisciplinary. So medical engineering is completely multidisciplinary branch of engineering, which is very, very important. Now look here, what are the important things that you should be understanding? The knowledge of physics, chemistry, and biology. I have not shown mathematics here. Of course, mathematics is required if you are going into a particular branch of engineering in this biomedical. But biology is very, very important to understand the concepts of biomedical engineering. The ability to learn interdisciplinary topics. This is very important. You cannot be actually telling that, no, I don't want to study this. I'll study only mechanical engineering and health in biomedical. You need to learn everything. Good analytical skills, programming skills, data literacy is important. And you should be capable of understanding clinical requirements and provide solution. This is also very, very important. For example, you want to give a solution for something. For some of the, for example, a person wants to have a prosthetic arm. You should understand what is the clinical requirement, and then only you can provide a solution. What are the job opportunities you have? There are medical research institutes which actually hire our biomedical engineers, medical equipment manufacturing and also service industries, healthcare industry, prosthetics and the orthotics industries, of course, in the software and IT industry. All of us are actually eligible for getting into software and IT industry. Lot much demand is there, so one can explore more after this particular session is completed. Now I'll get into another branch of engineering. It is called aeronautical and aerospace engineering. Aerospace engineering is a primary field of engineering concerned with the development of aircraft and spacecraft. It has two major and overlapping branches. One is aeronautical, another is astronautical, and both of them put together has come aerospace engineering. So avionics engineering is similar, but deals with electronic side of the aerospace engineering. So this is also multidisciplinary in terms of it involves mechanical engineering, electronics engineering, computer science engineering, and a part of civil engineering as well. Now you can see that the CAD drawing of an aircraft, the rocket engine before actually being launched. This is the space shuttle in the space, and you find the aircraft actually on the runway. You also find an aircraft engine under the bay of service. You also find a service engineer or a flight engineer in the flight who will be sitting in the flight and then assist in controlling the flight also. These are many, many more branches of aerospace engineering. It's a very interesting one. There's a question for the participants here. Poll number 7. One will become a pilot after completing UG or PG in aerospace engineering. Whether true or false. So it's open for the poll now.
86% around participants are saying no.
That is correct actually. Basically, I will tell you one thing. If anybody wants to become a pilot, you need not study aerospace engineering as an engineering part of it. Of course, this part of aerospace engineering will be taught in the pilot schools. But once you become an aerospace engineer, there is a chance that you can actually still be sitting next to the pilot and helping the pilot in terms of engineering. So it is false. You will not become a pilot after completing, but you can become, but you will not become. That's the main difference between the two. Now see what are the branches we have in aerospace engineering. We have propulsion, aerodynamics, fluid dynamics and heat transfer, flight mechanics, satellite design, aircraft design, rocket design, material science and metallurgy, design CAD, CAM and automation, aero modeling, many, many things are there. Probably now you would have seen that how the drones are being used in for multiple purposes, including by the police and also in the COVID situation to track and also to use the medicines, etc., and so on. What are the desirable, the skills required for aerospace engineering? Very strong hold on mathematics like calculus, algebra, vectors, knowledge of physics, chemistry, and material science. And of course, you should also have a lot of ingenuity in three-dimensional space, innovation attitude to develop structural systems, good analytical skills, good problem-solving skills, love to work with aerospace structures. You should also be a good team player and team lead. Almost all engineers will be having this type of attitude and caliber or the skill. Everyone should become a very good team player and team lead to become a very good engineer. What are the educational and job opportunities? You can see the job opportunities for aerospace engineering, like aviation industries, aircraft component manufacturing units, aircraft service units, defense research organizations, space research organizations, all public sector and research institutes, and of course, the last one, software and IT industry as well. There are lot many multidisciplinary engineering branches are there, like mechatronics. This mechatronics involves mechanical engineering and electronics, which originated from Japan. Simple example I will tell you. Suppose you take a washing machine. It has a lot of mechanical components which are driven by electronic components and of course are programmed by computer science. Now this particular mechatronics actually deals more with that. There is also something called medical engineering, which is also very similar to biomedical engineering. And part of this actually emphasizes more on engineering part of it. Aiding medical situation, similar to agricultural engineering as well. There is another very interesting topic which is at present in great demand. It is renewable energy engineering. I'll show one slide on this particular one little later. There is also something called biospace engineering and many more. What is biospace engineering? People are thinking that can we grow species in space? Can we grow plants in space? And lot many experiments are happening. This is also very important for the future of the mankind. And that comes with the space as well as bio, and lot many are there. I have one more slide here to show the renewable energy and its importance. Renewable energy is that derived from the renewable sources like sun, wind, tides, ocean, geothermal heat, and the characteristics which are naturally replenished on a human time scale. And nowadays everybody is looking for it because our resources on the petroleum products are depleting. And almost every country is actually promoting renewable energy, and lot many opportunities are there. There are few courses which are actually offered on renewable energy. Even Amity University Gurugram has a master degree as well as one diploma degree and ITI degree on renewable energy resources. It's a fantastic one. The job opportunities are plenty. And in fact, I see that most of my students actually get employed as soon as they complete this particular course with us. Now there is the end of the seminar webinar I'm coming through. Please rate the usefulness of this webinar in giving an insight into the current trends in engineering education. How much it is successful? 1 below average, 2 average, 3 above average, and 4 is excellent. Your feedback is very, very important. And within the time limit, I have tried to cover up almost all the issues, but we require, of course, lot much more time to deal with each one of them in detail.
Thank you, sir. Before taking this poll, we had a FAQ session. So student has asked the question. So I'll be asking you. The first question that I that has been asked is a computer science engineering student, which course should be done related to artificial intelligence?
Which course? Once again.
A computer science engineering student. In artificial intelligence, he is asking which what are the options available and career prospects.
Vikas Tharda, can you hear me? Can you answer this question?
Yes, sir. Sir, we are running BTech in AIML and BTech plus MTech in AIML. So that course will be suitable for the student.
So can you please explain more on the career opportunities in it?
Sir, there are a lot of career opportunities in the machine learning and the deep learning aspects, because nowadays the machine learning and the artificial learning is at boom. You know, a lot of companies like Google, Microsoft, Facebook, they are developing a lot of softwares, okay, in the field of natural language processing, machine learning, artificial intelligence, like Alexa, the device, then Microsoft has also developed Cortana. So all those lot of data which we are having available with us, that can be easily dealt with the concept of machine learning. Okay, and machine learning has numerous fields, be it cyber security, be it marketing, be it prediction, be it classification, temperature prediction, rain prediction, even satellite image prediction. Even we can compare the images to predict whether a person is suffering from disease or not. So a person can become a machine learning analyst. He can develop softwares, he can develop chatbots, he can develop softwares, you know, which can automate the product. So there are so many opportunities are there, and a lot of companies are there which are, you know, hiring. If you are having a good technical skills, if you learn the concept well, I think just after the completion of course, you can get a good handsome job, maybe 80,000 to 1 lakh, you know, per month easily.
Okay, thank you, sir. The next question is, how IoT will be successful in the coming year? Can you please explain a little more about data science also, which is a challenging together with IoT for research and products?
Yeah, Dr. Vikas, you can answer this question.
Yeah, no issue, sir. No issue. IoT is, you know, is that boom also along with the data science. But let me clear you the basic difference between the machine learning and the data science. Though machine learning and data science is not much different, but data science is all about, you know, answering the various questions which you usually have with a lot of data, and mainly it concerns with the prediction, answering some basic queries. Okay, for example, given a lot of TV data, okay, you need to find out where the tweet was generated, where most of the users are in favor of the tweet, where most of the users are not in favor of tweet. Then a lot of data which is coming from the engineering field, a lot of data which is coming from the medical field, analyzing the data, a lot of data which is coming from Facebook, the data which is coming from the YouTube data, a lot of search queries which are there in search engines. So main thing in data science is the analyzing, is the science of data. Whatever data you are having, you need to clean that data, you need to, you know, have some machine learning algorithms, okay, you need to apply those algorithms onto the data. And once you have that particular data, okay, you can analyze. How you can analyze? You can analyze by visualizing the data or by running a lot of queries. Now, because data may be a lot, so you need a lot of computational power. Okay, and there are different kinds of algorithms. So not every algorithm can give you the same amount of, you know, result. So you need to compare different algorithms, and depending upon what kind of data you are having, you'll be having different algorithms. So studying of statistics, because it needs you know, very strong command on stats, a good knowledge of statics, and working with a number of programming languages which are meant for data science, like R programming, like SPSS and Python, will definitely give you an edge in the data science field. Now, coming to the IoT, IoT is all about Internet of Things, where we have the various devices and which we are making them intelligent, like your washing machine, your, you know, your computer, and then your fridge, all of your devices. Even let's say when there's a rain prediction, automatically, you know, as the rain droplets you know, falls on the window of the, you know, car, you know, at the wiper starts automatically. So what you have done, you simply made that particular wiper intelligent. And whenever, let's say, some particular item is less, or let's say it's not available in your fridge, so the fridge can automatically call to the internet or particular grocery shop. Okay, even yet, when you are at a particular home, out of your home, and when you want to switch on AC as soon as you reach the home, okay, so what you can do, you can directly control all your appliances of your home from the remote devices. Okay, so it's very, very interesting field. And similar to the machine learning, IoT also generates a lot of data. It also has a lot of sensors together. And from the sensors, take an example of the car, okay, the smart car, which we also known as driverless cars. So it has number of sensors, okay, together, which it collect a lot of data, and the data is processed. So IoT together with data science, IoT together with machine learning, you know, will definitely give you an added advantage. Hope I have given enough.
Sir, we are getting a lot of many questions. So I would request you to kindly please be in brief further.
What
are the
fine,
scopes
sir.
Of civil engineering in India? What are the scope of civil engineering in India? Is it still in trend?
Yes, of course. Basically, I see that whatever the civil engineerings are being coming out as successful graduates, immediately they are absorbed. To be very frank, I will tell you one thing. Compared to the other branches, the civil, mechanical, electrical, electronics, or and of course the renewable energy resources, they have immediate absorption. But only one thing is, people or the students should not compare the starting salary of many of these professions. In fact, if you look at the civil engineering, one can start immediately, become a contractor, A1 contractor, or an engineer, or a design engineer, and not many things. Starting from your municipality and also the Gram Panchayat, you require a civil engineer there as a position. And not many, you know, government organizations are there, of course, the highways, etc., and so on. So many, many are there.
Thank you. I think this is an interesting question that has been asked by Anil. I think he has mentioned that I will be joining MIT Gurgaon for electronics branch. Can you please share, like these days we are listening more and more electronics manufacturing companies are coming to India, especially from China. Will this improve the job prospects of electronics engineers?
Dr. Anil Yadav, can you take it up? Otherwise, I'll take it up. Okay, maybe technical problem. I will take it.
Sir, you take that.
Okay. Basically, when you look at many of the electronic components, if you remember, earlier it was Malaysia, which was actually leading in the world, and then Japan. And then, after, you know, the trend actually turned towards China, which actually mass produced many of these things. And in India, of course, we have some of the mobile manufacturing companies or the establishments. Most of them were limited to making an assembly of imported goods. But now, basically, we are developing many, many things, you know, many industries are coming here. And of course, after the COVID-19, everybody is looking that, you know, many, many industries will be entering into India, especially because of its, you know, the friendly environment, as well as the way actually people will respond, etc., and so on. And I'm also looking for a bright future in electronics industries coming in here. And of course, we are very good in making, I think one should know, though we were not actually able to produce a chip, actually, we were very good in making electronic gadgets. A lot of electronic gadgets are being manufactured in India at present. Next, sir.
The next question, sir, that I've received is artificial and mechanical engineering. I feel there is a lot of scope to work on it. Can you please explain more about it?
Is it artificial intelligence and mechanical engineering?
Yeah. The usage in between. The usage of AI and mechanical engineering.
Yeah, right. So far, I think Vikas Tata has talked many things about artificial intelligence and its application in many things. Please understand, mechanical engineering also involves a lot many things. For example, I'll just take an example. You look at what is the power producing trend from past 10 years in a particular hydroelectric power station. Now, artificial intelligence will be telling us directly that what could be the rise in demand for this power, and also it will say what could be the rainfall or what could be the soak which we will be having. Now, this type of application will immediately make us a combination of the application of the artificial intelligence and mechanical engineering. And of course, you will also find mechanical engineering branches, especially in Gurugram. Almost all the branches in engineering which we are teaching in Amity University Gurugram, a part of computer science and a part of artificial intelligence is being taught in the form of elective subjects and also open elective subjects, only to give them an idea like these are involved. And this is only a simple example. You take any robot, the robots are actually, the linkages are made by mechanical engineers. The movement of those has to be involved with, done with the part of electronics and computer science, and of course the artificial intelligence comes into the picture. A robot which can go and pick up something, a robot which can answer, etc., all those will come under this particular category. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
The another question that I have received is, I am more interested in civil. Can you please suggest the project and the industry exposure that MIT provides?
Basically, we have MOUs with multiple civil engineering, industries. First thing, basically, we have MOU with Metro, and we also have MOU with the highway engineering organizations. And we are also working with geotechnical institutions or geotechnical research institutes. And we also are actually having a lot of projects on environmental engineering, which is actually connected to civil engineering. So a person who would like to take a civil engineering actually can also put an inquiry in our admission department and probably get in touch with us. Then we can actually provide lot many evidences and also lot many opportunities as a showcasing. Thank you.
The next question is, choosing which branch helps in bagging a good rank in GATE?
Okay, this is a question which we people usually ask. First of all, let me tell you something. The branch of engineering which you choose here should actually be in line with your liking, first of all. And number two, suppose you are looking for the GATE, which one will be much better? And this is a very critical, a very, very highly discussed question. All engineering discipline in the GATE appear to be little difficult and little easy, and both the way actually it is a 50-50%. So don't go by that, which will be easy to crack in the GATE. There is nothing like that. Any branch of engineering you can take, and of course you have a main paper, the main paper will be on your topic only.
I have the next question is, I have some interest in semiconductors, resistors and all. Will it be good to choose electrical or electronics?
Dr. Anil or Dr. Ved can answer this.
So if the participant has interest in the semiconductors and the resistors, so it will be better to opt for the electronics engineering. Because in electrical engineering, the exposure will be for the the electrical gadgets, not the electronic gadget. And these belongs to the like the resistors and this thing. These are little bit towards the electronics engineering. But of course, both branches are similar in this way. So, but the question of the participants is, it should be through towards the electronics engineering.
Further, he has asked, I have some interest to gel up my engineering in computer science towards also. So, does MIT provide this option?
Anil, you can answer.
Yeah. So, Director Sir already mentioned, all the engineering branches are, of course, interdisciplinary. And as far as concerned with the software and IT, like if you are going towards the electronics engineering and even electrical engineering, so there are so many subjects which are related to especially the softwares like embedded system or maybe digital signal processing and so on. So there will be a blend of electronics engineers and plus the software engineers. So both will be there. Even if you go towards the mechanical engineering or other branches, then also there is the option for. Even in at MIT University Haryana, we are offering open elective subjects. So any students of any branch can take as an open elective from any branch, other branch. Like an electronics engineer can opt for one track from the mechanical engineering or maybe the aerospace engineering or computer engineering. So that for that is as per the choice of the particular student.
Basically, in Amity University Gurgaon, we have something called the open track system, wherein one person, see, for example, electronics person who would like to also get more knowledge and skills in computer science engineering, can choose those type of subjects continuously starting from third semester onwards till the eighth sem. And in the eighth sem, they can actually do a project work which involves more of computer science. I think that answers all these questions. Thank you.
The next question is, what are the career scope opportunities available for BCA student?
MCA?
BCA.
Okay, Vikas Tata, can you just take it up?
Yes, sir. Almost all the jobs, if you are good, see, sometimes what happens, the BCA student think that if I am not a BTech, I cannot get job. But we have got number of examples. I tell you one example of a student, Devesh. He is a BCA IT student. Even earlier, we had some student from BCA. So right after the BCA, they got job. Okay, so they can apply in any software industry, or even when we have placements over here. So they also prefer to take students of BCA. It doesn't mean whether you are a BTech or BCA or BSc IT. You should have the skills to crack the interview, and they will definitely get you. So all the jobs which are available for the BTech CSE students, they'll be available for BCA students.
Right. The next question is, can you explain more about robotics?
Vikas Tata, can you take it up?
Yes, sir. Robotics is actually more about mechanical engineering along with the artificial intelligence. So as one student earlier asked, the artificial intelligence and mechanical engineering, so we simply say that when you apply artificial intelligence to the mechanical engineering, the robots are created. So when you do robotics, the programming of the robotics, the AI part, and the assembly, the motors, the various parts, how they move, how various parts are assembled together, that we done into the robotics.